All right, everybody, let me walk you through lab packet number four and some of the things that you'll need to know and focus on. I've probably said this now many times, and if you're watching these videos right after one another, you're hearing it four or five times in a row, but starting at packet three, but now moving in for sure to lab packet four and five, the amount of information, the thickness of the packet goes up exponentially. So there's far more information to learn as we move towards the end of the semester for lab packet four and lab packet five. So a lot more information, probably gonna take you more time. The upside though is quite often you are more familiar with these kinds of animals, and that makes things hopefully better. So lab packet number four is for this week, we're gonna go all the way to, I believe, I'm gonna look it up here in a minute, station 45. So all fish. Including all the dissection images as well. I think that's station 45, but we'll see as we go. Okay, so lab packet four. First of all, if we try to scroll down here, the second page shows you all the taxonomy here, and you notice there's a massive amount of taxonomy of things that you could know. So what's important here is that you do need taxonomy, as you know, is always fair game. So I can have out a picture of an animal and say, what phylum is this in? Or what subphylum is this in? And you should just look at it and be able to go, oh, that's in subphylum vertebrata, or that's a cephalochordata, or so forth, or phylum chordata, okay? But if you look at all the orders here and all the super orders here, it gets very cumbersome. There's a lot. So for questions in which I ask suborder or order, I will give you this list here, because we're not doing this right now over here. This is next time. So we'll do that next time. But for this week, we're doing all these fish. And so if I ask you, if I have a picture of a great white shark out and I say, what order is this fish in? Okay. You don't have to memorize this whole chart. I'll give you this chart here, but great white shark will not appear on there. You'll have to look at the sheet and go, oh, that is, you know, the great white shark is somewhere right about in here. And so you'll see this sheet and go, oh, the order is laminiformes. Okay. This is the same thing we did with the fruit and the same thing we did with the insects, where I'm going to give you a certain amount of the information with the question. And again, if you didn't understand what I meant with the fruit, or you didn't understand what I meant with the insects, then it's important for me to go over it again because you're still confused by that. So we're going to do this with fish, and we're going to do this with reptiles, and we're going to do this with birds, and we're going to do this with mammals. And each time the rules are a little bit different. And so my job is trying to make sure you understand the rules so that you can succeed. You can't win the game if you don't know what the rules of the game are, and we're still playing the game. The game's a little bit different right now, maybe. Still a game though, right? Okay, so if I ask you, let's say I have a piranha picture, right? Or I have the piranha out, and I have the piranha sitting out. I can ask you all the questions related to it, and you're supposed to memorize those and know those. You're supposed to look at the piranha and go, oh, that's a piranha. Okay, so I'll get to that in a minute. I can ask you what subphylum it's in, and you should know that it's from memory, that it's a vertebrata. But if I ask you what superorder it's in, or what order it's in, I'm going to give you this whole sheet that you see here, just like it is here, except these common names will be missing. Okay? Those will be missing. So you'll have to look at the piranha and know it's a piranha. You won't see piranha on the sheet that I give you during the quiz or exam or practicum, but you'll have to look through here and go, oh yeah, it's right about here. It's this one. This is the one the piranha's in, and then that'll be the right answer. Okay? So again, it's not that you don't have to study it. It's that you study it in a different way. You can practice by, when you're quizzing yourself, you can quiz yourself when you're practicing by having this sheet without the common names to see if you can get them right. Okay? So again, you don't have to memorize them all because that would be too much even for Bio 2. All right? Now, that's the first part. This is a cladogram of the groups. It is nice to see how they're related. I won't ask you the cladogram. It's not a bad cladogram. There's nothing wrong with it. I think it's great. It's just, it's a little overwhelming. So I like to be very clear on what I'm going to ask you or not, so you study the right thing. So I won't ask you the cladogram. Okay? Fair enough. Then we get to the regular part of the practicum. And once again, just like everything we've done before, you should be pretty good at this by now. We have station numbers. We have things you need to know about it. You're going to write those things down as you go. And they're usually, you've done pretty well with that. They're usually a different color. And you can see like the highlighted words are where that thing goes. And so things like, when do chordates appear in the fossil record? It has a nice, in the PowerPoint slides that we give you, it has a nice answer to that. And that answer goes there. And that question, those questions are fair game on a quiz or practicum or that kind of thing. Okay? That should all be quite similar to what you've done before. There'll be no problem there. Same thing with all these questions here. Now, the part that is different, maybe, where we sort of switch gears a little bit, is from now on, all the animals that we have out, if we give you the name of the animal like you see here, you need to know the common name of the animal. Okay? So if we have a great white shark out, one very easy question I can ask you, in addition to all of these, which go along with it, is I can just say, name the animal. And you have to write down great white shark, or you have to pick that from a choice. Or I can have a hammerhead shark out, and you have to look at that and go, that's a hammerhead shark. Okay? So common name is now fair game anytime we give it to you. Okay? You might see common names written in pictures on jars and things of that sort. Those you don't need to know. You only need to know the ones that are in the packet. Okay? So all, and there's a lot of them, though, like the whale shark, for example. Okay? So if we have a picture of the whale shark out, not only do you need to know the questions for the whale shark, as you see here, you need to be able to look at that animal and say, what's the name? Name the animal. What's the name of the animal? Whale shark. Should be nice, hopefully, and straightforward at this point. Okay? And that goes all the way through all of these here. And let me see. I don't think there's anything out of the ordinary there. Piranha. There's our piranha, right? So same thing. If I have a picture of it, there's the piranha, knife fish. You might be asking, am I going to use the exact same pictures that you see online in your PowerPoint? And I don't want to say for sure that I will always use exactly that same picture. So far, I've been doing that. And I'll probably keep doing that. If you're playing the game well, that's probably a good strategy. But I'm not going to commit to saying I'm always going to do that. I might find a picture I like better somewhere, and I might use that. But certainly most of the time, and maybe all of the time, I'm going to use the same picture that you have either in your packet or in those slides. It should at the very least still look like that animal. I'm not going to pick something that looks drastically different from what you should know, okay, for sure. And again, this is a big packet, and just for this week alone, we have this week and we have next week to finish this packet off. Just for this week alone, we're going all the way through the fish, including the fish, the osteichthyes, bony fish dissection, and all the way down to the chondrichthyes, the shark dissection, which is station 45. So for this week, oops, that's too far. It starts all over there. So this week we're going from station number one all the way to station 45, which should be up to, in this case, I think about page 30. Okay, so hopefully that gets you started on what you need to learn for lab. I hope everyone's doing well, and let's keep on moving.